The manufacturer of Sputnik V submits a request to the Philippine Food and Drug Administration to amend some of the details in its emergency use authorization. This includes increasing the number of weeks between the first and second doses. The current interval between the two Sputnik V doses is 3 weeks. Sputnik.
They written us to say that they might be amending the emergency use authorization para habaan po yung time interval between the two doses. Parang very similar po ito do sa adenoviral vaccine natin na AstraZeneca, no, which we now give to 12 weeks. So hinihintay lang po natin yung scientific data do to support the claim na mas maganda pag pinapahabaan po yung time interval.
Sputnik V is also looking to register as a single-dose vaccine similar to Johnson & Johnson's drug. The FDA is awaiting data to verify that the Russian-made drug is effective as a single dose. The city of Manila is again allowing walk-ins at vaccination centers. Yesterday, Monday, vaccination centers saw a low turnout after the city government imposed a no-walk-in policy. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno decries the no-walk-in policy, calling it a failure. Because of this, long lines are back once again. The mayor is appealing to people for patience amid these queues. He assures them that there is more than enough supply of vaccines. Manila's vaccination centers are open until 8 in the evening. Get vaccinated or face arrest. President Rodrigo Duterte threatens to arrest all of those that refuse to get vaccinated against COVID-19. In his speech last night, the chief executive said that he's now thinking of ordering the Interior Department to seek out all those that do not want to get vaccinated against the coronavirus.
I'm just exasperated by, you know, Filipinos not heeding the government. Eh, total tayo dito. Wala naman tayong hangarin kundi kabutihan ng ating bayan. So that 40%, hanapin ninyo yan. Kayong mga barangay captains, task the DILG to do that. To look for these persons and kung hindi, I will order their arrest. Sa totoo lang. Why? Because if you are a person na hindi ka vaccinated, you are a career of a potential career. And to protect the people, I have to sequester you in jail. May mamili kayo. Magpabakuna kayo o ipakulong ko kayo sa selda.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Food and Drug Administration continues to urge the public to get vaccinated. The FDA's Director General, Eric Domingo, says Filipinos should not be concerned about the vaccine brands, as he emphasizes that all are effective against this deadly virus, and even so against the more contagious Delta COVID-19 variant.
So far, the data for Pfizer shows that for the UK variant, yung Pfizer vaccine po, mataas pa rin, nare-retain niya yung mataas na efficacy rate niya of 93%. Pagdating po doon sa Delta variant, although bumababa po ng konti, meron pa rin naman pong 88%, no, na efficacy against the Delta variant. So there's a decreasing efficacy as we get more mutations, but hindi naman po completely nawawala ang bisa ng bakuna. It's still a useful vaccine.
Mandatory use of face shields in public areas in the Philippines stays. President Rodrigo Duterte settled that debate Monday night upon the advice of health experts that say face shields offer extra protection against the threats posed by the more transmissible COVID-19 Delta variant. The president adds that the policy should be followed by everyone, both in indoor and in outdoor settings.
I will apologize to the Filipino people that this thing was being discussed openly. I'm constrained really to go back to the old practice because of this danger posed by the D variant. Kung wala lang sana yan, especially I said with the narratives that goes with it in the international news and even dito sa locally, it's scary. So I cannot afford to place the nation, the national interest of the Republic, by just, sometimes adopting this and being lenient to this. I said, I know that it is a very tedious, if you may, but it is really to prevent a disaster of our nation.
As infectious diseases experts back the use of face shields amid the threat of the highly transmissible COVID-19 variant, Dr. Edsel Salvana, a member of the Philippines' COVID-19 task force, says that the Delta variant is nearly four times more infectious than the original strain that first emerged in China. According to Salvana, it only takes mere seconds of contact to get infected with the Delta variant, while the original strain takes about 15 minutes of close contact in order to spread.
What's happening in Australia right now, where they actually had one limousine driver who ferried international passengers get COVID, the Delta variant, and then he went to a mall and just passed by some people, and those people got COVID. So this was just a few moments. So right now, with an abundance of caution, it's probably better to use multiple layers.
The health department reported 5,249 new COVID-19 cases Monday, the lowest daily tally in nearly 2 weeks. This brings the nationwide total to over 1,364,000. Active infections stand at 55,847, the lowest in 12 days. The death toll, meanwhile, climbed to 23,749 after 128 more people died of the disease.